So we study ambrosia symbiosis. It's a symbiosis, meaning that it's two life forms that live near one another or with one another. They depend on each other. The more accurate term is a mutualism, meaning that they mutualistically help one another in nature, out with whatever they're doing in life. It's a symbiosis between beetles and fungi. And specifically, these are beetles that bore holes in wood and fungi that help them get nutrients from wood. Here's an example. Here's a little beetle that bores a hole inside a twig. This is a very small twig. This is magnified. And then made a hole like this throughout the twig. And you see the white stuff inside? That's the fungus. It's literally a fungus garden. These beetles are gardeners. They plant fungus in wood, and the wood helps them get the nutrients out of it, and then they eat the fungus. Like sheep, they graze on it. You see, this is the little lawn of a fungus. And these little white things are the beetle babies, the larvae, and those also eat just the fungus. So even though they bore holes in wood, they're really fungus farmers. So the reason why we study it is, one, some of these beetles and fungi go a little bit crazy when they are moved by people from their native region into a non-native region. Let's say you take a beetle that normally lives in Asia and you move it to the United States, and here it causes damage. We don't quite know why, but that's just what happens. So when we people mess around with nature, sometimes it causes huge damages, and this is a perfect case. The avocado industry in Florida may as well end pretty soon because of this, because of one species of a beetle and one species of a fungus that turn out to be very pathogenic to it. They're from Asia. Nobody studied them before they started to cause damage. Now, here we have it. A massive damages to our avocado industry, and now if this spreads to California or Mexico, even worse. So there is a reason to study those relatively obscure organisms, because you never know what they do. You have to study them first. You need to know them first, and then you understand how they relate to us. And in some cases, the relationship with people is not friendly. So that's another reason why we actually need to know about these obscure pieces of nature.